you very much. It's our version of Beatles' Here Comes the Sun. Before that was our take on the jazz classic Take Five. Both of those were recorded on a CD that we released last year that was recorded right here in this house up in Sound Hole Studios under the expert guidance of Scott Jacobson there. So
cool.
We love Woo! Scott.
Thank you.
And we're thrilled that he and Melissa have invited us back for our fourth year here. What a treat. What a nice tradition this has turned into. We can't think of a nicer place to be right now. So, and thank you all for being here to listen. For those of you who are new, welcome. And those who are back, thanks for coming back. It's a real treat. So we're going to shift to some Christmas material now. We'll be hearing a lot of that for the next hour or so. Christmas Day. This is our take on the hymn, The Angel Gabriel from Heaven Came.
Thank you.
Thank you.
long as I can remember in my time knowing Tim Mulvenna, I've been asking him if he'd be interested in playing a completely solo drum or percussion piece. And he has always turned me down until this year. I don't know what happened. Not like I've been especially good this year. But anyway, this next one's gonna, well, Tim's gonna share this with you. You wanna tell us about it, Tim, please?
Yeah, a little bit. All right. There are not too many places to play a solo drum piece. And there aren't too many pieces written. There are drum solos within songs, but not often do you have an environment to play a drum solo in. If I'm doing a jazz trio gig in a restaurant, they don't want to hear suddenly a drum solo piece. So it has to be in a concert setting. And there was a drummer who started this trend in the 1950s, named Max Roach, who wrote, on one particular record, wrote quite a few, two solo drum pieces. This is one of them, called The Drum Also Waltzes. And it's a little bit of a rite of passage as a drummer. You have to, at some point, learn this and try to do it. But it should sound like a standalone piece. So let's see if it works.
Thank you.
Next one we haven't revisited much since it was recorded back in 2009. I enjoyed it when we recorded it, and then since then it had somehow lost something. Every time we would play it, it just didn't feel quite the same. And so it sort of just got neglected over the years, and this year somehow we found a way to breathe some life back into it. It's got some life now. So it's breathing.
Much like the story.
Yes. So, anyway, we hope you enjoy this. Those of you churchgoers might recognize this. This is out of the Presbyterian hymnal anyway. This is Good Christian Friends Rejoice. I'm sure it's known outside of Presbyterians. Presbyterians didn't. It's actually a German folk tune from the 14th century. Medieval Latin. Something to do with John Mason Neal, 1853. Thanks very much. We're gonna play one more before we take a break. And this is another one that's kind of a newer, older one. Although this one was never recorded, it's sort of been bouncing around for years, kind of surfaces and then it sinks and surfaces and sinks. And I feel the best it's ever been. So anyway, hope I didn't just overhype the whole thing. Let's see. Anyway.
It killed last week.
Thank you. I think it helps us in July. I'm glad you brought it up.